Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and yesterday Apple released watchOS 8 Beta 3. This is available to developers, and unfortunately it's not yet available to public beta testers. Usually it will come out the same day, later in the day, or the next day. So far, we haven't seen it yet, so hopefully we'll see it as soon as tomorrow. But along with this, we still haven't seen the public betas of other versions they've released. So Apple released iOS 15 Beta 3, iPadOS 15 Beta 3, tvOS 15 Beta 3, and macOS Monterey Beta 3. So all of those are available to developers, and we're still waiting for that public beta. Now, this came in at a fairly large 654 megabytes. That's on my Series 6 Apple Watch. That's a pretty large update for a beta install. So it's pretty large. They must be fixing a lot of things, and they have fixed quite a few things, and they've updated some features as well. So let's first take a look at the build number. We'll go into our settings, then we'll go down to General, then About. Now, as you can see, the build number is 19R5302F, and this particular build has some changes and updates in it, like I said, and the first one has to do with focus modes. So if we go back to our main watch face, go up or scroll up here or swipe up, go down a little bit, you'll see that we have Do Not Disturb turned on. It's its typical sort of purple icon. And if we change the focus modes on the phone, they'll now change with a corresponding color. So if we go into a focus mode, you'll see we have Do Not Disturb, and maybe we want to go to Home Evening. There it goes. It changed by itself. And now it has a blue icon to match. So we have a blue icon. If we do the same thing on the phone for maybe we'll go to sleep. This one does not seem to turn on its own. You have to go back in and then swipe up and sort of turn on sleep from the watch itself. So you can go in and then you'll see the corresponding color. So you hit done and now you have the sort of teal green color there as well with sleep. So as you switch between the different modes, we'll go back to Do Not Disturb. We'll turn this one off, and then again, Do Not Disturb. It should turn on by itself on the watch. So it's nice that it corresponds and has a matching color to go with it, just so you have a color-coordinated idea of what focus mode you're actually in. So it's nice to see them add that nice little touch to this update. Now, something else they've updated has to do with settings. So if we go into settings, and then we go to General, under General, scroll down, we'll go all the way to Storage. This has been updated with a more graphical representation of what we had with our storage. It's more similar to what we have with iOS, for example. So you'll see we have 10.8 gigabytes of 32 gigabytes used, and it sort of splits it up by color, and then you can see the different things using storage. And then you can go into, say, podcasts, and you've got your app size, documents, and data, for example. So you've got all of these different things broken up. It shows you your different messages, what's using data. And so it's nice to see a little graphical representation that's a little bit nicer than what we had before. So that's been updated in beta 3. Now, another thing they've updated in settings has to do with workout. So if we go down to workout, go all the way down, under workout, there's power saving mode, but below that is auto pause. This used to say running auto pause. So if we tap on auto pause, we can turn it on or off. And what that allows is for it to automatically pause. It says running workouts when you stop moving and resume when you start moving again. So it's something that has been there for a little while, but they just changed the wording from running auto pause to auto pause. So it's just a slight change visually there. Now, something that's pretty major for those of you with a Series 3 Apple Watch that are having problems installing updates, and that includes iOS as well, is you can now install an update if you have less than 500 megabytes of storage available. You no longer have to wipe the device so that you can install the update and go back. It should now work after beta 3. So that's a great sign that they've allowed that. And I think that goes along with the different storage, so you can see what's using your storage, and then you can clear that up a little bit. But as long as you have around 500 megabytes of storage, they have not given a limit, you still should be able to install that update. So it's great to see them do that. Now, as far as overall issues or known or resolved issues, as far as known issues, there's still 14 issues remaining. Now, this is not a big deal. This is generally just letting us know what they are. And you can see those in the feedback app on your iPhone. So if you go into feedback and then you go to your inbox, you can see notes and known issues, as you can see here. So it talks about the different known issues. And if you're having an issue with your Apple Watch, make sure that it's not listed here first. You still may want to report it or not, but if it's listed here, just know that they're already aware of it. Also, there's resolved issues as well. So there's about 16 resolved issues in this update, and one of those has to do with that storage I told you about already. So you can see here, There's the note for it. You can now update your device using software update if less than 500 megabytes of storage is available. There's also fixes to things like dictation, for example, where that should work properly. So there's been a lot of resolved issues, fixed an issue that caused maps to quit. That was in beta 2. So you can go back and see what they've fixed all the way through all the different updates. And if you are having a problem, be sure to report them in the feedback app. Now, as far as battery life overall, well, I've been using this all day. I took it off the charger around 7:30 or 8 a.m., and it's currently 5:18 p.m. If I swipe up here, you'll see I have 55% of my battery life. So under battery, I've got 55% remaining, and it's doing pretty good. I don't leave it on a low power mode or power reserve or anything like that. Let's go ahead and take a look at the overall health. As it has gone down a little bit, I charge it every night. So we'll go down to battery health. And on my Apple Watch, I've used it every day since new, and I have 95% of my capacity left. This is pretty typical. 80% after 2 years is good, so we're doing fine here. And I just charge it on a typical watch stand, so it works fine with that. So I'd say it's okay battery life. It's not amazing. However, it could improve in the next day, but generally I can get through about a day and a half without a problem with it. If you're working out, streaming music, and things like that, it may be a little bit worse. Now, for those of you that have asked me, should you install watchOS 8 Beta 3? I normally say, unless you have an extra watch or you don't mind being without it for a while, if you have a problem, then go ahead. But unfortunately, there is no way to roll back to watchOS 7 currently or a current public version until they come out with a new one that is later than this version. And that means you have to bring it to Apple to actually have them bring it back. They typically send these watches out, have it restored, and then send it back to you. I've had to do that before, and so I don't normally recommend anyone try out the watchOS betas unless they know what they're getting into. watchOS 8 has been pretty stable overall, but usually I wouldn't recommend it to most people. So overall, it's been stable. It's been working fine. I haven't had any bugs personally, but there are some known issues like I mentioned before. So it seems pretty good. I would expect within the next 2 weeks, we'll probably see beta 4. Typically, we're on a 2 week schedule, just like iOS. We'll see beta 4 in a couple weeks, and then we'll go to a weekly schedule, usually in August, with a release sometime in September. So expect that sort of release schedule. I've talked about that at length in other videos, but probably by the 28th of July, we'll see beta 4 if they're going to continue a similar schedule, and then mid to late September for the final release. So that's it for everything in watchOS 8 Beta 3. If you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, I'll leave a link to this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.